Hi, my name is Rich Hanlon. Welcome to this segment of Things That Make You Go, I walked into the backyard this afternoon and found something that many might see as truly horrifying. And it's perched on the tree behind me. I'm gonna see if I can pick it up and I'll give you a closer look. Okay, here you have it. This is a Dobson fly. You may have seen these before. And this horrifying creature, which is actually not that bad, it's actually really, really beneficial to have around. It's an indication that we have very good quality water in this area, in both the Susquehanna and Chemung rivers at Athens, Pennsylvania. These bugs are indicators of good water quality. And one of the reasons is that this is the adult form of the Dobson fly. The larval form lives in the water, in riffly sections of our rivers and creeks. And they'll live for about 3 years in the water. And once they develop to the point of emergence, the aquatic larvae will crawl out of the river, bury themselves in the mud, and then several weeks later emerge as mature adults with wings. Beautiful wings, nevertheless. See that? Wow. Very cryptically colored. And you'll notice that there's both male and female Dobson flies, and you can tell them apart by the length of their mandibles. This is a male because he has very long mandibles, and the female has short ones. Now, I'm not real worried about this guy biting me. He can try, but he wouldn't succeed because the length of the mandibles doesn't provide enough leverage to get a powerful bite in. The females, on the other hand, I'd be very careful about handling a female, but the males I'm not so worried about. Here we go. See, they're actually nothing to be afraid of at all. Made a new friend. Maybe this is a lapel if I want to go to a dance or something. Of course, there's also a chance he might decide to fly away there. Oh, there he goes. Oh my. He just fluttered off of my shoulder up to the branches of the trees. Let's give you a look at that. There he is. Hang. I just swallowed a gnat. There he is on the underside of the leaves of this red maple tree, and he's probably gonna hang out there until after it gets dark, and that's when they will become very active, doing what they have emerged from the water to do. They won't live long as mature adults like this one. They'll live only for a couple days to a couple weeks until they've had time to reproduce, and then they will naturally die, or as their bodies weaken, they very often become bird food. We will leave this one be with these parting words. You may not live very long, but I hope you prosper. I started off this episode by saying, welcome to this episode of Things That Make You Go, ah! But it's not really something to be scared of, is it? Now that you've seen the Dobson fly up close and seen how harmless, especially the male is, perhaps as you're walking around town this summer, you want to keep your eyes peeled for these magnificent insectivorous beasts hanging out on the sides of trees, on the sides of buildings, and they're very active at night. And so one of the places to look if you really want to find one is after the sun sets. Go to somewhere where there's bright artificial lighting, where you see the other bugs congregating, and look for those Dobson flies. I hope you find one. Well, thanks for joining me in my own backyard between the Susquehanna and Chemung rivers. I'll see you next time.